hey guys, I need to make a new update, so it's be really quick and easy and... Oh, I'm feeling a comic book pickup video. Let's get started. Hey guys, welcome to a new episode of Comic Book Pickup Videos. In this video, I'm showing you a couple comics. Got books in, I'll show those last. I got some stuff at the first one I'll show first, and then I did get one game. Was this first one? I'll probably show that first. And then I got, yeah, that's basically what I got, so let's go for it for the game. So then after, if you don't like the comic book, stuff, you can click away or whatever else it is. I got this for the Blue's Hospital for $2. A Tom Clancy Rainbow Six for the N64. I got it because I just didn't have it, and this is a game that I think for $2 was not too bad. I haven't played it yet. I know it's like a flip and shoot kind of thing. I haven't played it yet, but for $2 it's not that bad. And the rest of the stuff is Mango related stuff, and I got it at a thrift store. I paid a book of piece for these. This is Stoning Jump. And Stoning Jump book. One I didn't have, so I picked it up. It has a preview, they're gonna have the preview whistle in it, and it has a Shaman King, One Piece, Yuhawk. I'm not gonna say individually what chapters, but the thing what's in it, Dragon Ball Z. And it also has, and particularly I will say, this half or which we'll call it, it's a page. Dragon Ball Z Trunk Story, the Mama Warrior. Bonus like little story in it. That's not that cool, so I did want to mention that. Also like Yuhaka. I said Yuhaka, I meant How Did It Go? Naruto, I said Yuhaka, and you just really leave here. But yeah, the other thing about this is the team cover. I'm just trying to tone off. But other than that, I mean, that's too clean. I can get another one, all the mangas really, yeah, that's really the main part, but I can get another one, it was only $1, so I can pay. This one was, it had a number on it. This one was 21, and then say volume, and he had a volume, so I'm assuming it's just volume 1. So I got that. Also found this for $1. So another issue with Stoning Jump, I did not have, and manga related stuff goes like this, goes with, you know, this kind of stuff. This one, I was supposed in January 2009, Volume 7, Issue 1, so the first issue of Volume 7, so that's cool. And this one has in it, Naruto. It has Yu-Gi-Oh! GX, Bleach, One Piece. This is Yu-Gi-Oh! Man, it's only one stuff. I'm done with it. It's a pretty evil manga. And about my favorite, Bubble Bell. Apparently, my Bubble Bell is it's awesome. We used to have a full series, like the full one on that, in the manga form. But that doesn't hold my video entirely. But for $1, I was happy to get that. And I also got these two for $1. Yu-Gi-Oh! Millennium World Volume 2. Now that one wasn't $1, I just said $1. I'm really fucking up on stuff. But anyway, I'll censor that probably now. I got this for 50 cents. So I was pretty cool with this, Yu-Gi-Oh! Millennium World Volume 2. 50 cents, it was in pretty good condition. There's nothing wrong with this one. I think one of the books has a big piece. They also have Yu-Gi-Oh! Duelist Volume 1. I already had this, but I didn't really have. But they did this, Yu-Gi-Oh! Duelist Volume 11. And it was also 50 cents. As you can see on the back here. As you can't tell how easy that is to tell, it's taped. And I had the tape in and stuff. Also in this book, if you see this page, kind of torn. But one of the pages just had these like monster things on it, so I wasn't too. The other side has monster stuff too. It wasn't too bad, like I'm not going to complain too much. I paid 50 cents, and the only other thing about this book, one page in the book, had a little thing colored in the thing, I'm not really a little on that page. I mean, yeah, a lot of people are like, oh, you want to get it on you. If I see one cheap, yes. Like if I did something, I'll probably replace it. It's mine, so this one. But for right now, that's my copy, and it's, I'm going to read it and enjoy it. I like you, your duelist. Next, I want to say this, it's a little blind thing. That's why it comes out of those like, little machine thingies. It's blind, like a wrapper. Family, I was walking out of Food Line and I like, had some change with me, so I decided to use one because I had a family that wanted to like family, yeah, so I got that. So yeah, I got this little blind wrapper thingy figure. I don't know what they call figures, whatever you can call them. Next is comic books. These are like, I guess somewhat new stuff. This is considered new stuff. First thing I picked up with, I got to that Books of Marion. Yeah, Deadpool, next issue of Deadpool, which is 44 that I needed. I was super happy to get this, finally get this, and I really enjoyed this. I thought this was the last issue. It is not, it's like the second to last issue, it's the kind of
I was like, okay, I enjoyed it. I had a lot of fun with it. I enjoyed it. Definitely what I was expecting, so yeah. It was really good, so I enjoyed that. Black Broken was also really good, and they had also the last issue of Deadpool. The Death of Deadpool. Issue 250, or aka issue 45. I really enjoyed this. The other thing about this, I wasn't really jumping joyful with the price, because the book theme, if we take a look at here, I don't know how well that's gonna focus. Obviously, it's $9.99, a $10 book. And I've seen books like this for $5. It seems like comic books keep, certain comic books like Marvel and DC keep getting more expensive. I'm not a big fan of that, but I'm not gonna really complain. I forgot it's a lot. And I could see this issue being like, let's see, that horse more than that, so I decided I'll just pick it up because this one is definitely fine. But it has the main comic in it. That's what the first thing is. You know, the final devil thing and dies, the whole planet is crafted, and anybody. Him and everyone else, he loved guys, and that was fun. Then it had a bunch of bonus mini comics, one of his girlfriend, one of the family, whatever, he's always one of the Apocalypse kid. He called Apocalypse, I guess. Then one of the other guy, who works for S.H.I.E.L.D. or whatever, teamed up with Spider-Man. Those Benjamin Franklin, who was cool for that Ben, was actually cool in it. The other guy who has like the beard and stuff, I can, like some of you guys don't know their names, or they haven't said the name properly, or didn't say the name of the thing. And then you have a Deadpool mini comic about him getting the Infinite Gauntlet, and then doing a Deadpool like rogue thing. And I thought that was really actually kind of funny. And I thought that was really a good. So I really kind of really enjoyed that. I thought that was the second best thing in the book. I really enjoyed that. It was really done really well. I enjoyed it. I also have the thing. I was saying it's like the guy who plays Agent Coulson talking to the guy who plays Deadpool, and then he starts yelling at him, because like, you killed Deadpool, that's shining on, and then they have the third page in the field. But I thought that was a funny little add-in thing they did. I also think they have this, called Deadpool. These are all tweets of people who's, you know, they send in tweets of what you think of Deadpool dying, or what you think of Deadpool, and all that kind of stuff, and it's like Deadpool tweets. And it's like 3 pages, I was like, wow. That right there shows that books are not beginning. I mean, I don't mind the book ending because it's like not too, like every book has to end at some point. And Deadpool usually doesn't make it past, I was like, he has one series like a past 100 issues, so, you know. It's not really good because like, he's always a popular character anyway, I like him, but. The thing about the comic is the next comic gonna have all the characters in it. Because we know the events really, then we know the long, because even though like, oh, Deadpool can't die, he can't come back, well. It has to be a universe. Okay, both universes collided, I got that. And even if they do, even if they collide and make one universe, there has to be a Deadpool in that universe. There has to be one of each character on that universe, maybe more. So Deadpool will come back somehow, or be a different Deadpool together or something, so Deadpool won't be dying. So I'm kind of wondering if all these other characters come back, because they're actually pretty cool and I like them. They cause both the worlds collide, so that's kind of, I don't know, it's not the best idea, because I like the Ultimate Universe, I think it should stay its own universe, and I like, you know, I think it's the end, but whatever, it's not, I'm not going to tell you about that. This one, the book that will never get ruined by anything that happens on the Ultimate World, or the other one, because it's the other one, now the Spider-Gwen. I think that's because no matter what happens in the regular universe, or the Ultimate Universe, this book will not get affected by, like, an event, unless it crosses over into her dimension, or comes into this dimension, because this is its own, like, universe. And I liked it, and I feel like, I wish there were more comics on this dimension, because this is like, takes off to me. I kind of think like, a lot of people like, should there be more characters from this, you know, like, one of our Frank, the only other character we see is the fourth season, but obviously Frank casts every year, the police chief or whatever, he is some police guy, and he's Frank Castle, so this, the Punisher is actually Frank Castle, well that's his real name, and he seems to be walking to the police and stuff, that's like cool. Away and changing it, like, it this whole book is different. Peter Parker dies, all this stuff. His Uncle Ben is, like, alive still, all this stuff, and it's, like, really gives you a grip, and it's really good, and we have this band called the Mary Jane, all this other stuff, and it's, like, really just probably the best book I've read so far, especially for Spider-Man book still. Probably my second favorite book. I like to say, like, art and every, that's really good. I think a lot of things that beats Deadpool over, like, this book, art. I like the art, especially from Deadpool, like, you have to start on what's the main point for this book. And if we go to finally to I Am Reading Comic Books on Saturday, because this Saturday is Free Comic Book Day, and also there's gonna, I probably, if they have the new issue of this, and it's just like, or something, I might pick it up. That was you too, because somehow... Yeah, so yeah. And I'll look with you too, because somehow both of you didn't get that, and I really want that. So yeah, that's all I got. As of most, that's for another video, for the next video. So as always, Facebook, you know, Twitter, all the stuff. Subscribe. And as always, stay epic.
We got win, yes! Win. Victory! See, it took me a couple times, but I got it. See, now the epicness flowing through me. You probably need too.
Talk to you, Spock. I don't know if you heard that. This is going to be a little bit now. For the other episode, because I didn't really have any blueprint, I'm really going to put something at the end. So yeah, that's what you're going to get. It sucks, but you're going to get it. Yeah, I get something at the end. So yeah.